I've got ideal painting conditions, lovely and warm. And my brand new spray booth, which is a tomato tent. I would have it outside, but it's a little bit breezy and it's decided to bugger off down the road once before, so won't have any of that again. Right, mate of mine has had the same crash helmet since the mid 80s. Yeah, I think I might as well do him a new one, give him a bit of a treat. He doesn't know about this yet. Let's see how we get on. So the first colour we're going to go for is a bit of a pearl white. To prep it, all I've done is just mashed it up with a bit of scotch cloth, some panel white to degrease it, right, 7 coats in, empty can pretty much, leave that 24 hours now and I can get mashed up for next stage.
The next day.
This is all mashed up, ready for the blue candy. Just keep on going with that stuff until it looks right. So that's 3 coats of candy and I'm happy with that. It's come out as a nice blue. So I'm going to give that a couple of hours to flash off now and then we'll mask up ready for the red.
3 hours later.
We get a copyright strike for the ice cream van. Again with 3 coats in. I think we'll call it that. It's come out a nice deep red. Let that bake off for a few hours. Ready for clear coat.
3 hours later.
Right, I've just knocked the masking tape off. It's come out alright, I'm quite happy with that. Couple of little bits, you can just see where the paint's caught on the edge. It'll come out quite right, but I think what I might do, I might shade that in with the airbrush a little bit anyway, because I do have a little plan for this. Overall, very happy with that. So I'm going to let it cure off for about 24 hours, knock back the nibs and get some clear coat on it, ready for the next phase.
The next day.
Right, keyed it up with some scotch cloth, give it a wipe over with a bit of panel wipe, let's get some clear coat on. Right, voice over time because the neighbour's having some work done on the house, so lots of music playing, lots of noise. I managed to chuck 4 coats of clear on and all I'm going to do now is just leave it to cure off for a few hours and move on to the next bit.
3 hours later.
Applying stencils to a curved surface is a pain in the ass, but I think I've got it all, so a bit of gold size.
I love gold! get too many air bubbles in. And give this about probably about half hour, 40 minutes to go off because it's a bit warm in here. Right, that's at half an hour. Feels about right. Not like I'm any sort of expert or anything, but let's go for it. Homemade spinning tool, a bit of aluminium with a chunk of velvet on top. Don't know how well this is going to work. Is that working? It's doing bits. I'm not an expert by a long shot. Never will be. That'll do. Let's get it off. It's looking okay. It's caught a couple of tiny little bits there, the tweezers, but I'm going to paint that anyway. So get the airbrush fired up. Right, no pressure.
Black, black, black for the sky and the sea, black, all black, like the procession of night that leads us into the valley of despair.
Righty, let's see what sort of mess I've made. Quite good. I'll leave that until tomorrow, let it flash off, and then we'll get some clear coat on.
The next day.
Right, that's four coats of clear on. 24 hours, we could polish it up. Polishing my helmet for now.
The next day.
There we go, helmet done. It's come out okay. Looking at it. A couple of minor imperfections, but overall I'm not going to chase them because I'll probably end up blowing through the bloody clear coat. Hope he likes it. So thank you, Tatiana. And thanks for watching.